everyone, my name is Deepti Mittal. Welcome to GradeUp. So guys, in this video lecture, we are going to study computer organization. If you are from computer science branch, you might have studied this subject in your fourth semester. So in this video lectures, we are going to study each and every topic which is important for your computer organization. The basic funda which we are going to follow is to cover this subject in such a manner that you can prepare for your competitive exams for CSE, such like GATE and so many other things. So in this particular video lecture, we are going to take a quick overview of CO, which are the important books for CO, so that while studying, if you get some doubt, you can refer that book. Second thing, we are going to discuss the weightage analysis of CO in your GATE examination. Third thing which we are going to discuss is topics we are going to cover in this video lecture, or the plan which we are going to follow for studying computer organization. So let us make a fresh start with computer organization. First of all, we will discuss weightage analysis of this subject, computer organization CO, in your GATE examination. For this purpose, I will take the last 5 year analysis. See, in GATE CSE 2018, the most recent paper this year in February, it was asked for 6 marks. In 2017, in paper 1, it was asked for 11 marks. That is a huge count. And in paper 2, it was asked for 6 marks. In 2016, in both papers, paper 1 and paper 2, it was asked for 6 marks. And in GATE CSE 2015, paper 1, it was for 3 marks, paper 2, 8 marks, and paper 3, 5 marks. In 2014, paper 1 and paper 3, it was for 7 marks, and in paper 2, it was asked for 8 marks. So, if I have to calculate the average for which this subject is being asked, I can say it is being asked for around 8 marks. That is, every year you are going to get around 8 marks from this particular subject. If you are going to prepare this subject, you will have a chance to score 8 marks. And if you are going to leave it, definitely you will lose your 8 marks. 8 marks is a huge thing in your GATE examination. When it comes to GATE, na, every marks count, every single mark count. And when it is of 8 marks, what can I say? This subject is really, really important. But there is misconception. There is one misconception about this subject is, what everyone says, like, this subject is really hard for scoring. Yes, what I am saying here is, it is not that easy to score in this subject, but it is not like it is difficult to score in this subject. You have to be fluent with your concept. You have to be clear with your concept. You should have accuracy in your hand while solving the question. Then you can easily score marks in this subject. One more thing, when it comes to your GATE rank and when you want to score a good rank like under 100, then nothing is like which is less important to you or something is not there which is more important to you. Every topic is equally important for you. Okay, let us see which of the book you can refer while studying if you get some doubt.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any update from GradeUp.
See, computer organization and architecture by William Stolling. This book is really good for the concepts of computer organization. In this video lecture, we are also going to cover some architecture portion which is required for us. Okay, you can refer this book for your doubts. You can refer it for your study also, but it is not that easy to study from a standard book. You can study, but it requires a lot of time. And you cannot afford to waste that much time on a single subject because you have to prepare for each and every subject. So my suggestion is, while studying, if you get some doubt, while solving problem, if you get some doubt, you can refer that concept in this book. This book is really helpful and the language is very good for this book. Let us see what is CO. CO stands for computer organization. Now you might be thinking like, why we studying computer organization? We are CSE people, we deals with software. So why we need to study computer organization? See guys, we deals with software, that is correct. But for the working of those software, we should know the basic functioning of the computer. Okay, this is the reason we study computer organization. You know, DLD. DLD means digital logic design. Digital logic design deals with pure hardware. And your operating system is pure software. But this CO lies between this DLD and this operating system. So it is bit of hardware. You are not going to deal directly with hardware. You are going to deal with software. But note that the level of operating system. So this CO is really important for us to understand the basic functioning of our computer system, so that we can design the softwares which are really, really effective in their work. So what we are going to study in CO basically deals with computer system, that is functionality of the computer system. We are going to see the functionality of our computer system. Now, I have introduced one new term, which is computer functionality. What you might be thinking this time, what is computer functionality? First of all, do you know what is a computer? We are studying this thing from our first standard. If you remember the definition was there was, computer is a electronic device. We have studied that thing in our first standard. So, let us make a professional or a real definition for the computer. What actually computer do? You give some input to it, it process it and give you output. And this processing is carried out by whom? Computer. But this processing is defined by whom? Us. Programmer defined that processing. We are the definer of that processing. We define that processing. So, computer functionality is to process the data under the control of the user program. What is the functionality of computer? Computer functionality is execution of your program. Okay, you will give some input and it will execute your program. Now one new thing is introduced here. What is program? Now you will say, what is the program? Program is the sequence of instructions along with the data. Now again new term, instruction. If I take the English meaning of instruction, what is an instruction? Instruction is some command which you are giving to someone. Same for computer, instructions is the command which I want to give to my system. I give some command, I want to perform system some work, then I will give a command to it and then execution of that command will be carried out over here. What is an instruction? Instruction is a binary code associated with some operation and some data. You are giving some command, that command is represented as operation in our computer system, and that command will be executed on some data set which is known as data. So now you are aware what is instruction and what is data, and these operations which we are going to perform in the system will be represented using opcodes. Your instruction contains opcodes. Opcode specifies the operation which you are going to perform in the system. Okay. This is the basic of our computer. Let us move towards next thing, which is computer architecture. See, there are basically two architectures. What is architecture meaning? Architecture meaning is design. There are basically two computer design. First one is von Neumann architecture. Second one is Horvath architecture. Or the second name is single memory architecture. Another one is multi memory architecture. And these two architecture are designed on the basis of program storage. Let us see what is the difference between these two architecture. Before moving towards that thing, are you aware of main memory and secondary memory? You know, our system has two memories, main memory and secondary memory. Our CPU directly deals with main memory. Let us start. Von Neumann architecture or single memory architecture says your CPU requires your program to be in main memory for its execution. That is, your program must be in your main memory. It is named as single memory architecture because your instructions as well as your data will be stored in single memory, which is main memory, or one more name for it is RAM. Both instruction and data can be stored in a same memory. You know, RAM is a volatile memory. Every time content can change. That is, using this von Neumann architecture, you can execute millions of programs. Whatever you want to execute, load that into your RAM and execute it according to the given data. So this von Neumann architecture is the best idea for your PCs. Your personal computer, you use them for different purpose. You may write something in notepad, you may play games, you may play music, so many things you are using. So this von Neumann architecture is best for your PCs. This is the architecture which we use in our real life or general life. There are two processors on von Neumann architecture, 8085 and 8086. We are going to discuss whole CO on the basis of these two processors. It is having 64 KB RAM and it is having 1 MB of RAM. Okay, let us see what is the difference in Harvard architecture. Harvard architecture is also known as multi-memory architecture. See here, you are going to store your instructions in ROM and data in RAM. Since you know, ROM is read-only memory, it is a non-volatile memory. Whatever data once inserted, you cannot change it. That is, it is going to execute the same program over the different data sets. You might be thinking where I can use this. Suppose in airplane or aircraft systems. Same program has to be executed again and again, but data set is different. For those purposes, we can use Harvard architecture. It is named as multi-memory architecture because here we are having multiple memories for storing multiple data. One is for data, other is for instruction. That is all about my computer architecture. Now we will discuss the topics which we are going to cover in upcoming videos. See, first topic which I am going to cover is basic organization. This basic organization will tell you the basic functioning or the basic components of the computer system. In this, I am going to discuss memory organization, input organization, input-output organization, then instruction cycle. We have discussed that functionality is instruction execution, then how you are going to execute that instruction, CPU organization, and the steps or the sequence, whatever required for execution of instruction. These are the basic building blocks for this particular subject. After discussing the basic organization, we will move towards next thing. Then we will study about instructions. Whatever we are going to study there is instructions and addressing modes. Your instruction is going to carry some addresses. Then we are going to discuss instruction, addressing modes, types of instruction, transfer of control. These will be used for function executions. Let us see the next thing which we are going to discuss. Next thing we are going to discuss ALU, data path and control unit. Till now, we have discussed the basic organization of CPU. Now, we are going to discuss the parts of CPU. We will discuss ALUs, control unit, and data path, data lines, and so many things. Control unit, micro program, register organization. That is, now we will discuss internal things inside the CPU. The next topic which we are going to discuss is instruction pipeline. Pipelining is used for enhancing the speed of your processor. Then we will discuss how we can enhance the system performance and how we are going to implement that analysis or the enhancement and what are the limitations which we got from that enhancement. Next topic which we are going to discuss is memory organization. First of all, in our basic organization, I'll just tell you that how your memory is connected in your system and what are the basic things which are required. Now here I will discuss simultaneous hierarchical organization, basic cache organization to speed up the process, updation policies in my cache and so many things about cache memory. Afterwards I am going to discuss the input-output organization. Then I'll discuss floating point arithmetic. This floating point arithmetic is used for storing the very small or very large size data. We will see how it helps us in effective storage of very small size data or very large size data. So guys, this was the plan which we are going to follow to complete our subject computer organization. Guys, see, for everything there are two approaches in your life. Either you can choose a simple path or you can work hard and choose a path which is difficult. Difficult path will give you some problems in starting, but will give you an easy life afterwards. But a easy path can give you fun in your initial phase, but you have to face difficulties in your further life. So guys, my suggestion is, so you can use that approach to this subject also. Either you can leave this subject or you can study this particular subject. My suggestion is, take some pain and study it. After all, we are having only one life. Why we don't do the things in great way? Why we don't study for 1 year and get a good rank and get at some nice place and then enjoy our life? Because whatever field you are going to choose, you have to do work very hard. In every field, competition is there. There is nothing like you have no competition, just sit and having fun and living a great life. There is no concept like that in real life. That happens or exists in movies only. So my suggestion is, take this subject seriously. Try to be focused while studying this subject and make a motive like, I have to score these 8 marks. I am not going to lose any one of the single mark. That should be the strategy. So guys, that's all in this video. We will look forward for our next video lecture. In that video lecture, I'll start with basic organization. And the first topic which we are going to study is memory organization. Thank you till that time. Thank you for watching this video.